Hello. Over the last few weeks, I have been getting together a recording project for you whilst concerts in the church have been put on the back burner. It's been so good to be back in St Andrews making music again with three wonderful musicians. Emily Hultmark, principal bassoon with the Philharmonia Orchestra, Robert Van Rijn, trumpeter and cornet player extraordinaire, and Susanna Fairbairn, whom many of you will have heard singing in our Christmas concerts, a fabulous up-and-coming young soprano. I will put biographical details of all the musicians on the website. If you enjoy these recordings and would like to show your appreciation, the bank details for donations to the Concerts in Caversham bank account will also be found on our website. Although we were able to give concerts in October and December, clearly, with only 40 people in each concert, the demands on our concerts kitty were considerable. At this point, I'd like to say a huge thank you to Nigel for making all of the recordings possible. However, the really great news is that on the 22nd of May, there will be a concert with an audience of up to 100 people. Ariel Lanyi, a prodigiously talented young pianist, will play a programme of Mozart, Brahms and Albanith, and the tickets are now available through the website. I look forward to seeing you there, and meanwhile, I do hope you will enjoy these musical offerings. We have all thoroughly enjoyed getting them together for you.
This is somewhat of a luxury for me to put together a few pieces that I love and have discovered. I'm going to begin with Ravel's Enfant de Habanera, and further along in the programme I play another piece by Ravel, and both are written for voice, transcribed for various instruments, but it's wonderful to be able to play it on this. At the end of the programme, I will also play some of my own stuff, which is with electronics, which is why I have quite a few wires and things down here. Part of the last year has had its little tiny bit of silver, in the sense of I've managed to pick up a few things that I love to play. And Ravel, Sibelius, writing my own stuff as well is a big part of that. So there's a bit of a folk music theme going throughout here, and Ravel's imagination, his feel for the kind of Spanish side, which was from his mother, features quite a lot here as well. Thank you. Finnish tune, which I discovered fairly recently. It stems from a folk tune, Madre nomi fa Monica, which in the 1600s was a fairly well-known folk tune that refers to a text that was a very common theme of the time, where a young girl was protesting against having to be dragged away to be a nun, and I think the bassoon represents the girl in this case. And I love it, it's such a gorgeous tune. And I've been really inspired by a recording that I came across, which was for arranged for sort of baroque instruments. So.
Thank you.
by Sibelius. I was researching a lot of Sibelius at the time, as I was going to do a bassoon class on Sibelius's works. He writes so amazingly for this instrument in his orchestral works, but I had very little knowledge of his songs. And this, from listening to it, you might not detect much Sibelius in it, but it's beautiful nonetheless. It's a hymn for Thais, the legendary Athenian courtesan from the myths. And here's the poem which the hymn, the song, is set to. Thais wants Helen of a Zeus begotten, unforgettable, unforgotten, doomed to pass deathless through new incarnations, ever the wonder of new generations. Thais, fair Thais, whose mystic smile still through ages us men doth beguile. Thais of Egypt and Helen of Troy, essence Olympic and earthly alloy. Who saw thee incarnate shall never forget thee. Thais, I would that I never had met thee. Based on a Swedish folk song, which is called Låt till far, song for father. I kind of changed the title a bit last year because I created it actually for my mum's 60th birthday, so that it was song for mum. I love playing folk music. I feel much more at ease than any kind of classical stage setting. So this is a chance for me to show what I do when I mess around with electronics and wires and loop pedals and stuff, just slightly touching the surface of this whole different world, which I've learnt a lot from my dad. So this is Låt till far, a traditional Swedish folk song.